I'm Brooke McKenna Richards, and I am happy that you are here on this channel and on this planet. Now, you guys really liked my psycho boss story time that I just posted, and I really think it's a great way to kind of inspire you guys with real life stories of things that can happen and just lessons you can learn from every experience. So in the story time, I talked about the fact that I had to take some time off for my dad because he had a heart attack. Now, this happened in about September of 2015, so a little over 2 years ago now, which is crazy to think that it's been that long because it doesn't feel like that long. But I thought that this was such a cool story about that such a dark time that I should share it with you guys, because not every dark time is all dark. You just have to look for the light and see the light in it. Now, if you don't believe in paranormal or ghosts, spirits, anything like that, this isn't a pushy video on you. If you don't believe in that, completely fine. Think of it as more as a miracle or just seeing the positive in a situation. And yeah, it doesn't have to be about paranormal. That's just something that I'm really interested in right now. I love watching story times about it. Haley Reese is my favorite if you want a suggestion on who to watch. And so I just figured this would be a great story. My mom and dad were actually out on a little vacation by themselves. They are adoptive parents, and they were on like a little trip for adoptive parents. I was at home watching the kids for them, and that night, I had no idea, but my dad actually had a heart attack. He never really had many symptoms. He had kind of the heart burning, but he never like passed out. It was never too traumatic. He was still like, he didn't feel like it was necessary to go to the hospital for those pains he was having. He didn't think of it as anything. And it got so bad that night, and just the pain in his chest, that he thought, okay, well, yeah, let's take me to the hospital. So my mom drove as fast as she could to the hospital. She had no idea what was going on. And they got to the ER. Everyone was looking at his EKGs. He was having the symptoms by then of a heart attack. And everyone was saying, your monitor is fine. Like, the EKG was showing up completely fine. And so they were like, okay, maybe he's not having a heart attack, but he's having these symptoms. They couldn't figure out what was going on whatsoever. So my dad sat there having a heart attack for 5 hours waiting for the doctor to come in, because nobody told the doctor that it was urgent because they didn't think it was. So we sat there, and when the doctor came in, he realized, oh my God, I think he actually is having a heart attack. It's just not showing up. So he was wheeled into surgery. My mom went to the waiting room to wait on him, and that's when they put in his stent. Now, during this time, when my mom was in the waiting room, there was like rarely any people walking around. This was at like the middle of the night. I think he went in to have his surgery at like 6 a.m. So this was like 4, 5, 6 in the morning. No one was really in the waiting room. It was just her, this very small area. The hospital that they were at, very small, and nobody ever really walked by. My mom was on her own, sitting there, freaking out, panicking that her husband was going to die in surgery. And this lady walks in, this little old lady my mom described as like whitish blonde hair, very like small dainty woman, old lady, walked in the door by herself, went in, went to the bathroom, came back out, and just like stopped and stared at my mom. The only two in the entire room, she just stopped and stared. And my mom was just kind of like, and she walked over, and she asked, you know, may I ask why you're here? You know, my mom said, my husband just had a heart attack and he's in surgery right now. And she was like, oh, you're too young to have a husband that's had a heart attack. Which my mom, my dad was in his early 50s when this happened. So she's 10 years younger, so she's in her early 40s, or she was. And so, yeah, she kind of was. And my mom was just like, yeah. The lady told her that she was actually there with her mother, and she had choked on something at the nursing home, and so they were there. They didn't think she was going to make it, and then like went on to just like talk to my mom and tell her about like her cochlear implant she had in her ear and how she'd been deaf her whole life, and then she got the cochlear implant and she can hear out of one ear, and just like random stories. And my mom was like calming down through this process and really like relaxing a little bit, and the tension that she'd felt from being all alone was like dissolving slowly. And then this woman asked her to, if she could pray with her. and she grabbed her hands. And my mom, we're not really like a religious family, but we're not against anything either. So my mom grabbed her hands and they prayed together about my dad. And this lady kind of said, you know, your husband's gonna be okay. He's gonna be okay. And she was so sure about it. And my mom, like, she finally, she, not peace, but it helped, this lady being there for her. And right as soon as she was done praying, the doctor walked in and called her back and said that my dad was out of surgery. So at this point, it was like a little after 6 in the morning. My mom went with the doctor and he parted ways with this little old lady. She went back and she was talking to the doctor, and my dad was, he was fine. He was okay. He was recovering in his room. And the doctor, once he finally, you know, like got everything out and was talking to her, he started drawing on a piece of paper. And my mom was like, what you doing? And I actually have the piece of paper with me, and it's going to look like an elementary schooler drew it, but he was in a hurry. He was trying to, he's not an artist, okay? He's a doctor, and I promise I didn't draw this myself. My siblings didn't. He actually drew this himself. Now, what he said was that my father was basically a miracle. It was a miracle that he was alive. And yes, a heart attack, you know, you have a heart attack, it's kind of a miracle you're alive. But he started telling my mom, no, this is a true miracle. I don't know how he's alive. He should not be alive. And my mom was like, so he drew this out for her and explained that the artery in his heart, now I'm not a doctor, so I'm not gonna explain this perfectly, but this is how she even, like, she wrote it down on this piece of paper, everything that he had said, because she didn't want to forget it. But he had basically said to her, the blocked artery is like the main artery in his heart. It was 100% blocked. He should have died. But somehow, some way, my dad had magically grown, magically, you know, a miracle, whatever you want to say, had grown two pathways near that artery that was sending blood and oxygen to his heart. And without those little pathways, whatever they're called, doing that, he would have died instantly. It would have been a completely different outcome from this heart attack. And that's why this came into play. My mom can't remember for the life of her, like, what this really is, but we believe, we went through it right before this video, we believe he was trying to say that this was the stent and these two little lines are not supposed to be there. And those are the ones that his body made for him to survive, that they saved his life. And the doctor was like, I've never seen anything like this before. I can't explain it to you. I can't tell you why they're there or why he survived, but it's a miracle. And that's basically what he was saying. So, I mean, it took a while for that to really sink in, because at this point, my mom and my dad had been up, well, my mom had been up all night, my dad had been in surgery, and they really didn't comprehend, you know, how big that was. But the doctor just kept saying, you know, this is not normal. And so I remember this whole process, we kept calling him Superman, and the doctors would call him like Superman or superhero, because this is just like abnormal human behavior and human, like, bodily, whatever you wanna call it. Like, it's not a normal body function to make those. I know that it's possible, and doing some research, apparently it is, like, it's not common, but it has happened to people before. Now, throughout the stay at the hospital, I think they were there for like 10 days. It was really starting to sink into my mom what the doctor was saying and how strange it was for this to happen to my dad, and magical, how much of a miracle it could be. And then she started remembering that little old lady the night of my dad's heart attack. Now, she had been there for 10 days roaming around this tiny hospital wing, and not once did she see that old lady again. She started looking for her. There were like glass walls around some of the rooms, and she would like go and, like, you know, just kind of like, you in there? You in there? No, she didn't see this old lady ever again. She didn't see like another little old, like an older lady than her, like that could be her mom. She didn't see her around the rest of the hospital in the cafeteria. She never saw this woman again. Now, whether you want to call that an angel sent down to just console my mom, or just a little old lady that wanted to help, I do believe that there are people put in our lives for a reason, and in certain situations are there to tell you everything's gonna be okay or help you through situations. I do believe that there are people the people are always where they're meant to be, if that makes sense. So that's a way you could look at it if you don't believe in angels or paranormal or anything like that. But I, thinking about that whole situation, I just totally think that it's possible and amazing that that could have been an angel that was sent down to talk to my mom, because she knew she'd already saved my dad's life. She knew that she'd already put those passageways in my dad's heart. If the blood and the oxygen were getting there like they were supposed to, she knew that she'd saved my dad's life already. And so she just went to console my mom and say, look, girl, don't worry about it. It'll be okay. In return, you know, had her pray, which we don't do very often, and kind of brought her more into a spiritual place. I think that whether it's paranormal, whether it's spiritual, whether it's a miracle, it all has to do with believing in light and knowing that it is there. Even in the darkest of times, there is light there for you. And sometimes it comes to you like that old lady, sometimes you have to go to it, sometimes you have to really search for it, but I think it's always there. And it's, I don't know, I love that story. I mean, of course I love it, it saved my dad. And whether that was just, you know, his body making it, or a miracle, or God, or an angel, I believe in the light. The doctor had actually told my mom that this particular heart attack where this artery was blocked is called a widowmaker, and because their spouses are left widows. Rarely anyone survives this heart attack. So you can't tell me that's not some sort of miracle life plan from somewhere far bigger than us, or an angel that came and saved him. I don't know. You guys let me know down below what you think, but please try to be positive and don't bash me for like my opinion or me titling this about an angel, because I'm just in awe of the world and what can happen and the endless possibilities of life and opportunity, and it amazes me. So I'm not here to tell you what to believe in. I'm not here saying I know what happened. I'm just here telling you an inspirational story and to remind you that everything will be okay if it's meant to be okay. And if something goes wrong in your life, there is light. There is light. I believe in that. Or there will be if you can't see it yet. So thank you for listening to my story, and I guess my family story. If you want more inspirational stories, please thumbs up so I can keep telling them. And I just hope that this put a smile on your face or made you think about the world in a different way and life in a different way. I know I'm so thankful for my family and for my dad still being here, because my life would be completely different without him. And if you guys have any similar experiences or have ever heard any, please leave them down below. I would love to read about them, because it's such an interesting topic to me, the fact that this actually happened. I want you guys to know that these stories are sincere from the heart. I wouldn't lie just to be inspirational or whatever. Like, these are things that I think genuinely can help you, and stories that I am not necessarily like, I don't love, you know, telling like everything about my personal life, but bits and pieces that I know can help you, I'm willing to share. So remember to spread beams of light everywhere you go. I love you guys so much.